Hey, what's up guys? It's George Eng again. Apa khabar kamu semua? Welcome back to my property channel. Today's topic is about syarat nyata, whereby there is nothing stated in the syarat nyata. Di mana syarat nyata tu tertera kosong saja, tidak apa-apa pun dinyatakan dalam syarat nyata, whereby nothing is stated in the express condition, and sometimes they'll just write NIL, N-I-L. So in situations like this, it becomes a big headache. Yes, because most agents, they are not familiar with it, and they get confused and they start to panic, because in the syarat nyata it is stated NIL. Sometimes it is blank, and sometimes there is just one line being cross on it. Yeah. So apa yang terjadi ialah bila syarat nyata itu adalah kosong, di mana tidak ada apa-apa syarat dinyatakan ataupun dia tertulis NIL, N-I-L. So agent hartanah semua rasa confused. What is the next step? Yeah. So topik video kita hari ini ialah untuk menetapkan macam mana kita boleh menyelesaikan masalah ini. Jadi sebelum itu kita harus menentukan apakah dia syarat nyata dalam surat hak milik itu. So in the first place, we have to understand what is syarat nyata in our property titles. Okay, here's a definition. Syarat nyata adalah suatu arahan atau larangan yang dikenakan dan dinyatakan di dalam hak milik bagi maksud mengawal penggunaannya. Okay, mempunyai kuasa untuk mengenakan syarat nyata yang bersesuaian dengan undang-undang ke atas mana-mana tanah yang diberi milik. Syarat nyata yang bertentangan dengan undang-undang tidak boleh dikenakan, seperti tanah yang bermilik. Okey, macam ni. Semua tanah tanpa mengira bila ianya diberi milik ada tertakluk kepada apa-apa syarat nyata yang tercatat di dalam dokumen hak milik itu. Okey, so based on the definition here, you can see that syarat nyata is a what you call an arahan or a larangan. There are only two meanings to it. Either is an instruction or a restriction that is imposed and that is stated in the title of that property. And property in this sense can be a piece of land or a built up building or structure on it. Okay. So that is the definition of syarat nyata. So now I will show you some examples of syarat nyata. Okay, this is the title of a property in Kajang. Okay, here is stated syarat nyata is bangunan perniagaan. Bangunan perniagaan. So there is no dispute on this. It's expressly stated bangunan kediaman. Okay, quite straightforward on this. Okay, here is another title. Under syarat-syarat nyata, it is stated tapak perniagaan. Tanah yang terkandung dalam hak milik ini hendak digunakan sebagai bangunan untuk kediaman dan perniagaan sahaja. That means it combines both lah, kediaman and perniagaan on this property. Okay, here's another title in Penang. Okay, syarat-syarat nyata, it says first grade. The land comprised in this title shall not be affected by any provision of the National Land Code limiting the compensation payable on the exercise by the state authority of a right of access or use conferred by Chapter 3 of Part 3 of the Code, or on the creation of a land administrator's right of way. Now here is another different title, Syarat Nyata. Tanah ini hendaklah digunakan untuk bangunan kediaman bagi tujuan rumah pangsa sahaja. So it is expressly stated this is for a residential building for the purpose of rumah pangsa sahaja. Okay, here we have another different title. This is a HSM title, where in the syarat nyata it says untuk bangunan perniagaan. So it is expressly stated that this property, this piece of land is only for bangunan perniagaan use and not for anything else. So we do not have a dispute on that too. Okay, here's another one in Mukim of Petaling, where syarat nyata it says bangunan kediaman. Yes. So it is for a residential building again, so we can't do any soho or sofo or sowo, perniagaan, only for kediaman use only. Now your problem is this. Sometimes you come across titles whereby under the syarat nyata, it is either stated new or is blank, or they just draw a line to cancel everything on it. Tengok ni syarat nyata, dia orang sudah cancel. Yeah. Dan kadang-kadang tidak tertera apa-apa di bawah syarat nyata ini. Dan kadang-kadang dia orang akan tulis NIL di bawah syarat nyata ini. Okay, look at this title carefully. What can you see here? Syarat nyata? Nothing is stated at all. All they have is just one small hyphen to say that new. The meaning is new. There is no syarat nyata. Tidak ada apa-apa jenis syarat nyata yang tertera di bawah ini dalam surat hak milik ini. So when there is no syarat nyata, what is the next step for you to do as an estate agent? To clarify the matter with your client. Okay, the solution is very simple. If there is no syarat nyata stated in your title, the next thing you do is you look at the category penggunaan tanah. Category penggunaan tanah under the National Land Code, we only have three types: pertanian, bangunan, or industry. Only three types of category of land use. It's either agriculture, building, or industrial use. So we check if there is no syarat nyata, then we need to fall back on the category penggunaan tanah. So usually it's either agri or it's either bangunan or under industry. So in this case, this is also a very old title where it is also stated tidak dinyatakan, no category of what you call penggunaan tanah. In one of my earlier videos, I have explained when category is not stated, then what is the next step you should do. So if you want to know more, when category penggunaan tanah is not stated, then please go back to my channel and search for that video which I did previously on that. Okay, for today's video, when syarat nyata is not stated, we will fall back on the category. So it is very simple. If syarat nyata is not stated, then we look back at the category that is in the correct category, category penggunaan, bangunan. Okay, from there, the next thing we need to do is we will need to check on the zoning where this property is located, whether the zoning is for industrial use, untuk agriculture, untuk industry, untuk rekreasi or whatever type of zoning. So untuk memastikan zoning di mana tanah itu terletak, maka kita kena refer kepada jabatan perancang. Yes. So it is not stated and we know the category of penggunaan tanah, then we need to refer back to jabatan perancang to confirm the zoning where this property is located. Yeah, Jabatan Perancang is the best, what you call, authority to confirm on what you can do or use on your property. Because they have their own zoning plans for that particular location where this property is located. So in summary, if your syarat nyata does not state anything, it is new or it is blank, then you make sure that the penggunaan tanah category is stated on the title. If it's not stated, never mind, then you check with Jabatan Perancang on the zoning. Once the zoning is confirmed, then you know what can or cannot be developed on that property. So it's a very simple solution. Just check on the zoning with Jabatan Perancang, and if your property is located, say in Selangor, we have a what you call online website to check on that zoning. Even if your property is located in other states, for example, the state of Penang, Perak, Melaka, Johor, Negeri Sembilan, and so on. There are also online sites that we can check on the zoning without having to go to the Jabatan Perancang. Semuanya senang saja, brother. No problem punya. Kena check zoning sahaja. Jika korang tak tahu, boleh tanya team leader yang award winning, team manager atau principal kamu lah. Senang je. Jika dia orang tak tahu, suruh dia orang tengok video ni lah, dan subscribe kepada channel saya. Yes, property and estate agency is a very simple business. So don't make it complicated by all the what you call confusing lectures given by your other parties, external parties or your in-house trainer. Just follow this what you call content of my videos and you guys should be all right. So if you like the content of today's video, please click like and please subscribe to my property channel, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Jika korang rasa content hari ini memberi manfaat, tolong klik like dan tolong klik subscribe selepas menonton video ini. So that is all for today's video. I see you guys again. So take care guys. Okay. Okay brother and sister, kita jumpa lagi pada video yang seterusnya. Sekian. Thank you. Terima kasih.